Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To start this video, there is a Space News article about another payload that SpaceX will be launching on a future rideshare mission. It says space manufacturing startup Varda Space will launch its first spacecraft on the Falcon 9 in early 2023 to demonstrate the ability to produce a wide range of materials in microgravity. There is another astronaut moved from a Starliner mission to the Crew 5 SpaceX Dragon mission. This JAXA article says JAXA astronaut Koichi Wakata, currently preparing and training for the ISS expedition, has been decided to board the fifth operational Crew Dragon developed by SpaceX. The launch is scheduled for autumn 2022 or later. Michael Baylor has posted a tweet about SpaceX's next launch, which will be a Starlink mission. He said SpaceX will launch a batch of Starlink satellites from Vandenberg Space Force Base this Sunday, October 17th. Launch time will be between 10:34 a.m. and 11:34 a.m. Pacific. Over in Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site as work progresses. This cable carrier was recently spotted being moved to the launch site. At the launch site, the second catching arm was moved onto the installation structure. With the chopstick arm installation with the tower getting very close now, apparently a carriage roller fell off the tower. RGV Aerial Photography posted a picture of it and asked if they had a backup. Musk responded and said, yeah, on its way. The new wider high bay foundations continue to progress. Here's a view of the two new tanks recently delivered to the propellant production site. There is an article posted about SpaceX being sued over the Cameron County beach closures. It says Texas environmentalists upset by frequent beach closures to accommodate tests by Elon Musk's rocket company SpaceX filed a lawsuit in Cameron County State Court that claims the practice violates the state's constitution. I wanted to share something interesting that was posted on Reddit, which is this NASA page. According to this page, the heat shield tiles on Starship are called star bricks. I also wanted to point out that it says targeting Starship re-entry observation opportunity near March 2022. NASA Spaceflight posted an article about the new Raptor factory being constructed. It says the new Raptor factory is now rising out of the ground at SpaceX's rocket development and test facility in McGregor, Texas. Tasked with supplying Raptor 2 engines to the Starship program, SpaceX is laying the foundations for its rapidly reusable rocket. This vacuum Raptor engine, RVAC-6, was spotted in a tent. There was a barrel section that recently collapsed due to high winds. A vacuum Raptor engine was spotted being installed under Ship 20 as they prepared a prototype for a static fire. Chris Burgin posted a tweet of Starship 20 receiving the vacuum Raptor engine. Musk responded and said, Starship is a hard problem. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, yesterday's closure was cancelled. They did have a closure for today, and Mary even received a notice about a static fire test. As I was recording this video though, today's closure was cancelled. Today, some new dates were also added for testing. There is an additional primary date of Monday 18th with backups on Tuesday 19th and Wednesday 20th. So, as of now, it's looking possible there will be a Starship 20 static fire tomorrow. The heat shield tile installation on the Starship 21 nose cone is coming along nicely. Here's a view of the Ship 21 nose cone barrel section with tiles being installed. Super Heavy booster 5 stacking is continuing in the high bay. There was also a tweet posted by Chris Burgin of booster 5's first grid fin being installed. Like usual, I have to say thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Girl for being out there filming the amazing content. Also, thank you to Nick Ansuini, who is out in Boca Chica filming the amazing content too. Plus, thank you to the NASA Spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.